Hello. In this video, we're going to talk about custom metrics. There are over 300 Facebook ad metrics available for use in automated rules. However, sometimes we need a metric that Facebook doesn't provide. With Revealbar custom metrics, you can create your own customized metrics and use them in your automated rules. This is one of my favorite features in Revealbar. For example, you can create a custom metric to calculate your own conversion rate, to make an efficiency ratio, or even to create a moving ROAS or CPA target. Let's first take a look at how to create a custom metric, and then I'll show you some ideas of how you can use them in your automated rules. You can find the custom metrics builder in the assets section. Custom metrics are available for all the ad platforms we have. So they are Facebook, Google, Snapchat, and TikTok. In this video, we will create them for Facebook ads. Let's create a new one by clicking on New Custom Metric button. Here is where you can write your formula to make a custom metric. It works by using the default Facebook ad metrics in conjunction with your own numbers and mathematical operators. Let's start by creating our own conversion rate metric. Of course, the formula can be written in any way you want, but I'm going to choose website purchases divided by unique link clicks. Please keep in mind that you can also choose metrics from the attribution platforms from Facebook. So from the integration section, they are AppsFlyer, Weekly Reports, and Hyros. But at the moment, we're creating the metric from conversion rate. So here is the formula. We can choose whether this custom metric should be applied to any ad account or just for this ad account. And I'm going to select any since it's not specific to one ad account or another. Let's give our custom metric an appropriate name. For example, conversion rate. And define its format as a percentage metric. Please note that custom metric format only affects the way the numbers are displayed. In other words, it just appends the relevant symbol to the value. For example, if you select percentage format in the custom metric, it will just append the percentage sign to the conditions in the rules. And let's give it a quick description. For example, purchase and click conversion rate. The name and description will become important to help you organize your custom metrics when you start to make a lot of them. Now that we are done, click Create Metric, and now we can see it in our library of custom metrics. You can also create a custom metric based on Google Sheets. So if you know how to populate a Google Sheet with your data, you can then build custom metrics based on it and use those in your automation rules for Facebook, Google, Snapchat, and TikTok ads. We also have a separate video for it. You can find the link to it in the description of this video. Let's create one more metric as a single variable. Let's say we have a goal this month, either from a client or a manager, to hit a certain ROAS target. And if the ROAS target changes next month, we can just update the value for the custom metric, and then all our rules using that custom metric will be updated. Let's say we have a ROAS target of 2.5. I can click number instead of metric and enter 2.5. Since this metric is probably ad account specific, I'll select ad account and choose reveal bar. So give it a name, for example, ROAS target. Set the format to numeric and give it a description. And then click create metric. So that's it. Let's modify one of our rules to use our new ROAS target custom metric. In our increased budget rule, I'm going to change the first condition from website purchase ROAS greater than or equal to 3 to website purchase ROAS greater than or equal to a ROAS target custom metric. To do this, we'll be using the metric comparison feature. So click the gear icon and select metric. For the second metric, we're going to select our new ROAS target custom metric. Make sure it says greater than or equal to 1 times our custom metric and choose the same time period. Now our condition says if the website purchase ROAS is greater than or equal to our ROAS target, increase the budget. And again, if we ever decide to change the ROAS target in the future, this rule will reflect that change. Pretty convenient, right? Please also note that it's possible to edit or create a custom metric right from the rule builder. So you can either edit it right here, or you can create a new one. And if the custom metric is ad account specific, it will be seen only when the specific ad account is chosen in the rule. So that's it. Custom metrics paired with metric comparison is one of the biggest benefits of using RevealBot over Facebook native automated rules. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.